Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board, and I know the county department will want to have somebody speak on this. This is for renewal for calendar year 2013 for our ambulance service with advanced ambulance. You will note that the ambulance service, they have asked for a few modifications to their agreement that we would, of course, probably go through. A few of them, I think we're all in agreement with. One is some language in regards to the ambulance equipment itself. Right now, we have, it has to be less than 5 years old, plus 175,000 miles. We'd like to take out the age and say it has to be less than 175,000 miles on it. And some of the equipment within the agreement as well, like the cardiac monitors, now they can be updated by software alone. They don't actually have to replace the piece of equipment. So that would just be terminology to make it equitable. The next item is regarding staffing, and currently some of the Georgia license names have changed, so it would just be clearing up the license names so that they match what is by the state of Georgia. The third item is one that it would provide authorization or ability for the Forsyth County firefighters to drive an ambulance in absolute time of need. Evidently, this has happened in the past. It has been a need, and this we'd like to ensure that the county is covered by their insurance. It is usually, and the fire department can talk more in detail, is if the person in need needs additional help, that the ambulance providers do not have to stop what they're doing. They can get into the back of the ambulance and continue working on the patient, and the fire department can drive the vehicle to the hospital. They also, Advanced Ambulance does dispose of our medical waste for us. We deliver it to their location. It's about one bag every 3 months, but it is a help to us, so we like it. The last item is currently in our contract, there is a 3% provision for an increase annually, and that is what our budget is based on. Advanced Ambulance is asking for the calendar year 2013 to increase that by 10%, and then after 2013, go back to our 3% increase. The rationale they provided to us was to cover fuel costs over the past few years that they have absorbed, and they feel they cannot absorb that anymore. Just before this meeting, just before I came in today, J.B. Owens is here with Advanced Ambulance, and he also stated that there was one other item in regards to that cost increase, and that is because due to the increase of indigent persons using the service, they did not get as much payment. And truly, I just found out about that other rationale right this moment. The request is to renew the agreement with Advanced Ambulance for 2013 with the proposed changes listed items 1 through 4, but to retain the pricing at the 3% level for 2013 as stated within the agreement. If the board does go up to the 10%, the overall cost through the full contract cycle will be over $355,000. And I think Chief Bowman would like to make a comment. Thank you.
Commissioners, we have no problem with items 1 through 4. I would debate the issue on item 5. If you look at AAA gas prices, Chief Shivers is handing off to the county manager now. I show gas prices back to 2008 being fairly constant. Some spikes, some valleys, but fairly constant at or about $3.50 a gallon. I would therefore argue that particular argument is not valid. I would yield to the board as to whether or not you are going to consider 10% as an increase as opposed to 3%. The difference in a 3% increase and a 10% increase is $66,900. 2013 budget general fund has already been adopted, and that was not taken into consideration. Therefore, it's an unfunded liability. I would yield to the board. If the board had any questions about that with Advanced Ambulance, perhaps they might be able to put forth a little better than I have, but at this particular time, I cannot accept item 5. I would ask the board, relative to the item that has to do with the language change, that you consider a motion to amend the Forsyth County ambulance contract by deleting the current language in section 21A and inserting the language, quote, staffing requirements, each ambulance used for response to 911 calls shall be staffed with a minimum of one Georgia licensed paramedic and one Georgia licensed EMT intermediate for all hours that the ambulance is on duty. I've covered a great deal, Mr. Chairman. I am here with staff, Chief Shivers, who is the supervisor over Captain Hamilton, who is the board designated ambulance contract administrator. Mr. Chairman.
Chief,
on the page of the wording that you suggest, does this indicate in any way that currently we do not have a paramedic and one Georgia licensed EMT intermediate for all hours?
It does not mean that, Mr. Chairman. What it's doing is the current contract outlines some particular courses, such as pediatric. That is already covered in today's paramedic coursework, so it's not needed. They would be taking the same pediatric course twice. Therefore, the language that I've set before you now would clean that particular item up, more especially section 21A.
Chief, if I could ask you about the request for the increase for 3 years. My understanding is, by looking at this and the presentation, was the increase in subsidies is twofold. One of them being to help cover some of the fuel cost increases we saw in the last period, when we ourselves, I remember struggling with the sheriff's office about how are we going to fund that increase in fuel. I do know that we came. I came, and I don't know if any other commissioners came, back to the county several times to find out could they buy fuel through our supplier to help offset that increase in retail. They can't because they're not a government entity. So we've known I've known for as long as I've been on the board that fuel's been increasing and a problem for them to address. I'm not sure I have difficulty in trying to assist with that because my understanding is, and I'll ask Captain Hamilton to help me with it, is the service that our citizens receive is second to none. Very few complaints. I know that when I've had citizens call me and say that they couldn't afford the service or could they work out a payment schedule, of course I don't have the authority to do that. I would turn them over to Advanced and invariably they'll work with them. I mean, they're just a great contractor to this county, which means it's a great contractor to our citizens. You run a tight ship and do a great job at it. And I don't want to put a burden on you, but I'm wondering if there's somewhere we can meet in the middle to help them recover that, because they do provide such good service to us. And we do have ways to save money in other areas. Do you see any way to meet in the middle anywhere? Do you have anything we can?
Could I just, before you, I wanted to answer a question, but I just want to clarify something that they said earlier. You said it was about $360,000 unbudgeted. Is that correct?
$66,900.
Okay.
I think Donna was for 3 years.
This is just for one, right?
That was for 1 year. I gave you the total cost, right?
The total increase.
All right. I just threw two different things.
Could I ask Advance one thing?
May I have you on, Mr. Chairman?
Sorry, Chief. Mr. Owen, right now, if you prefer to, well, you should talk about it, you'll come back to the voting. What are you carrying on the books right now is debt service from people who are trying to pay, but can't pay, and are trying, what is your receivables running for county business right now?
For the county business right now, I can give you as of Monday or yesterday. We are looking at about $325,000 sitting out there. Maybe we're going to collect, maybe we're not. I'm also looking at year to date, $828,000 that we have to write off as bad debt. Through no one's fault, the economy, people losing jobs, losing insurance, it's getting to a point where there are fewer and fewer people able to pay. We do work with these people. We as a local business, we're part of this community. Mr. Rutledge, the owner, lives here. I live across the line in Cherokee, but if you go out in Westcott, you see the name Sewell anywhere, that's my maternal grandmother, but she came from here. So this is kind of home to me as well. We are associated by the general public as being a county entity, even though we're a private business. They think, since Forsyth County, by the contract on the truck, we're Forsyth County. So we have not pursued legal action.
You don't sue them, collect with or anything?
We try and collect. We do the best we can to collect. Some people, I mean, we'll work with them. If they want to pay us $9 a month, but no interest, and nothing.
So let me ask you then, if we didn't approve this, would that then cause you to maybe more aggressively pursue some of those past due accounts? I mean, the fact of the matter is you have to get revenue to provide the service, to pay the staff, to keep the equipment, and all that. It's got to come from somewhere.
Those costs are increased.
So for the board's perspective, I would like to see us consider something, because I tell you what, I get glowing reviews from citizens. Now, I won't be here in 30 days, but if they have to start pounding on people, our citizens are going to get upset, and they're going to think it's the county. They do it.
And
hold on, guys. Go ahead.
How many ambulances does this contract require to have in service?
6 24-hour trucks.
How many do you actually use sometimes?
There are times like yesterday when I'm going to use 12.
But how many do you have an extra one you put into the circle sometimes
and don't charge us? I have the truck, the 24-hour truck for advanced, which we use primarily for non-emergency services. But it is fully ALS, advanced life support stock, and staff that I put into service.
Do you charge us for that?
No. I was going to say that. And basically, the county gets a 7th ambulance at its disposal that's not on the contract. Plus, we have one spare truck in case of mechanical issues. We can just switch them over into that truck and go.
I do have a couple of questions for Chief, if you don't mind. Do you want to answer?
Commissioner.
If the county opted to run their own ambulance service, we would have to buy 6 or 7 ambulances.
That's
correct.
Do you
have any idea what that might run the county?
The first year would be right at $4 million.
And
in fact, $3.9 million for the first year. After that, it would be salaries and operating expenses, which is $1.5 million per year. You can take away the subsidy of almost $1 million we pay to advance now. So now to get into the black, you're down to $500,000. And that's based on a collection rate of, say, 60%. So to get into the black, you probably would cost you $3.8 million the first year, the funding mechanism, which is general fund. And after that, $1.5 million. But minus the subsidy that we're paying them now, which is $1 million. So I would think you'd be in the black within 3 years, if that. Did I answer your question, sir?
Yeah, it really does, thank you. And the only thing I have then is how long would we collect the fees, and could we do a better job than they do? If they're already in debt, $828,000 since inception of their contract, and $325,000 since this year.
If you had your own ambulance service, it would have to be an enterprise fund, not unlike the water department. You would hire a private contractor from the outside to handle collections, and they would take 7.5% of all dollars collected.
I just personally, I see a very small amount they're asking for compared to what the investment would cost us to start one up. But thank you.
Thank you
for having this number so I could.
Thank you. I got a question. Chief, you mentioned that the $66,000 was not in our general budget.
That's correct.
That's the total amount the extra 7% would come to.
That is correct.
Why didn't advance or someone come forward when we had budget time and ask for this? Instead of asking now, we do not have it approved in our budget.
So may I yield to advance?
Yes, sir.
I'm at a little bit of a disadvantage because Mr. Rutledge is a doctor's appointment. he set my timeframe on presenting this, but I believe this was in, had a lot of fun. That we used to, it was, not only was it October that I presented this to you, we talked about this.
It was after our budget period, it brought to our attention, sir.
Unfortunately, no excuse, unfortunately, I missed much of the month of August. I was in hospital with major surgery. Was last week of August was my first week back at work, and I spent maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours, like a half a per day. I apologize for that.
Mr. Grohn, have we ever had to go back in and look at our reserves and touch our reserves, and where is our reserve standing right now above the 25%? How many million do we have in reserve?
Oh, let's see.
Is this coming out of the fire fund budget, or is it coming out of general?
No, it's just general fund, it's independent service. So remember here, I think we're about $6 million above our 25%.
About $6 million in reserve?
Start this year, and this year we're in the black, and yeah, so we'll add some more to that.
So when we get black, are we able to take the $66,000 out of there comfortably without having to cause any grief to anybody?
I think so.
Easier than $3.8 million to start our own ambulance service?
I think $66,000 would be easier than $3.8 million.
But the other problem, Todd, is any increase in something is going to be based on the extra 7%. I mean, this is not a one-time.
This is a $300,000.
This is for 3 years, and it goes back to 3%.
And it goes back?
Yeah, but 3%
on top of the 10%.
On top of the 10%, you already agreed.
Also, I'm not sure why we're comparing buying ambulances when we have a contract.
I understand that.
They're good to our citizens.
If they're saving you millions of dollars or hundreds of thousands a year because it's better work for the private sector than to try to put your own together, I mean, it's the taxpayers' money we're supposed to be looking at ultimately.
Well, why have a contract?
It's only 1 year at 10%.
We just approved a bunch of people.
Dave got back to 3% in 2000.
Gentlemen, item number eight, we just approved multiple contracts increases because products work, they were unforeseen, and that's typically in a contract as well.
Thanks,
Jim. That was ready for a budget. This would not.
I believe I'd have to go back and look, Commissioner, but I know because I'm on the Finance Committee, I think there was no. Limited discussion about it. There was mention about it.
So this went on what he just said.
Well, I don't know what JB did. I know that as a Finance Committee, as a commissioner, I've been contacted. Would you consider this? And I indicated that I would be willing to look at it. This isn't the first time we've seen it.
Well, I'm not looking at it, but I don't want to increase our next year on the full 7% extra.
I think this is to come back and get even with the cost of the amount that they're writing off. And Commissioner, the fact is you're a businessman.
Yes.
If we don't help a little bit with it, they're going to have to collect the money from somewhere. And I would rather help them a little bit when we have a surplus. They're providing a great service. We're supposed to provide for the public safety, safety and welfare. We spent $130,000 on water fountains in a park for crying out loud. And I don't want them, they weren't budgeted. No, they weren't budgeted. I would rather help out a little bit than have them have to beat on our citizens who are having a hard time. It's public safety. This is what we do. It's like border lines.
But I'm reminded, if we're going to increase our 3%
it's a reset period like we do with a lot of contracts. That's the reason it's back before us today instead of a standard 3-year increase over and over and over. That's why it's back for a review because you have to look at what is actually occurring versus what you anticipated occurring. And we know, and we dealt with it, I've dealt with it for 4 years. Now, fuel costs have been tremendous for us to deal with the Sheriff's Office and the Fire Department. And we've had to find money to do it. They don't have that luxury. So they've come today to ask us to help them recover some of that cost. That's some of that $100,000 you came with. That's all. Let me go to the board's office.
And typically, the private industry does it better than government. I can't imagine what our write-offs would have been if we tried to run the thing.
Increase 1 year, but then don't base the future increases on an extra 7%.
I think they're trying to recover what happened in the past, not the future, is what the comment was.
Yeah, it's a reset period based on high cost.
They're just trying to recover what the cost factor fuel costs over the last few years hit them that was unexpected. And of course, in the future, it looks like they're going to stay the same, but going back up again right now. That's not, I mean, in the scheme of it all, if we're trying to run ourselves, it would cost us a lot more money to do it. And to keep them running and save us several hundred thousand to 500,000 a year and $3.8 million initial investment.
I think Chief Bowman said we'd be in the black in 5 years. Well, that 3 or 5 years, Chief.
If you want to start ambulance service, that's something to consider for next year, but it will take a little time. So if you give them 10% this year, you won't have to worry about it because it takes about a year to get yours out of line. So we'll be in good shape.
DeKalb County ran their own, and I may be wrong, Chief, you're more than welcome to chime in if I'm wrong about this, but talking to some of the firemen down there at one time when they ran their own ambulance, the firemen themselves quit because they decided to be firemen, not ambulance drivers.
Well, we're not talking about, they're not saying they're going to quit because of this. We don't have to start all the fire. We're just talking about raise right now.
That's correct. But it's a lot of war when you try to start your own. This really saves you a lot of money in the long run. I believe it does. I'm not arguing about this. Pull the trigger and vote on it. And Chief, sir, I assume that your fuel prices went up like the sheriff's did and like ambulance service did over the last few years as well, over what they were in 07.
They have, but we've been conservative.
I understand, sir. And unfortunately, you have a millage rate that affords you to have some reserve as well for those days. And
we do. Which
is there,
we
to
is there a motion from the board?
I'm going to make a motion that that we accept the renewal with Advanced Ambulance Service as shown on the book. And the one change the Chief has respectively given us.
21A.
Yeah, under the 21A, where it has a motion to amend Forsyth County Ambulance Contract by deleting the current language in selection 21A.
So you make a motion
to change of what now?
1 through 5 with 21A as presented.
Correct.
I'll second.
We have a motion. We have a second.
Just some clarification. Are we amending the language to say staffing requirements each ambulance use for response to 911 calls?
The chief. Yes. The chief presented, we'll put that in the book. That's correct.
And just for clarification, that's under item number 2 in the book, the language that the chief provided. So it's definitely covered.
Oh, it's already covered in the book. Well, thank you so much. Then you don't have to.
We have a motion. We have a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. And that passes 3-2. Thank you, Chief.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, Commissioner.
Thank you, General.
Mr. Chairman, was that time sensitive?
No, it was not.
So I'll go back to you.
Item number E, agreement for payment for the Water and Sewer Department.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This is for acceptance of an agreement with PayPal for use by the Water and Sewer Department. This will greatly enhance the customer service. They'll be able to pay online whenever they desire. PayPal is supported by our Clarkstown utility service providers. There is no additional cost on that side. For calendar year 2012 that ran, the setup fee is the $249, and then for calendar year 2013, it would be the $59.95 per month, which is approximately $719.40. With that, you get 1,000 transactions. It's anticipated that we'll have approximately 7,000 transactions a month.
Item under new business, item number 2.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. This is an item we discussed earlier. It is the renewal of our ambulance service contract with Advanced Ambulance for calendar year 2013. Advanced Ambulance has asked for a few revisions to our agreement, and they are listed here. There's a total of 5, and they've added one more that's not in your books. The first one is on equipment and vehicles. Instead of just basing it on age and mileage, it would just be based on the actual mileage and not the age of the equipment. The fire department is in agreement with that. The other one's on staffing requirements. The licensing company or the licensures for the state of Georgia has changed, and this is just to put it in compliance so it matches what the license actually are called. It will also provide authorization for Forsyth County firefighters to drive an ambulance in absolute time of need, and that allows the ambulance personnel to continue to work on the citizen as necessary. The item number four is that Advanced Ambulance has been and will continue to dispose of our medical waste. We deliver it to their location. It's approximately a sack full of disposal items about every 3 months. They have asked for one more item in here, is that we put in a buyback clause, that if the Forsyth County decides to start up their own ambulance service during this, they have a 5-year contract at present, during that period, that we'd have an independent auditor look at the equipment assigned to our contract, and then we could buy it from them. The last item is, in our contract, we have a 3% annual increase. They are asking for calendar year 2013 that that be a 10% increase, and then the calendar years after that, we revert back to the standard 3%. Our recommendation has been to renew the agreement with Advanced Ambulance for 2013 with the proposed changes. In your book, it'd be 1 through 4, but also with the buyback clause would be acceptable, but that we would retain the pricing as stated in the agreement at the 3%. Thank you.
Yeah, pleasure of the board.
Mr. Chairman, I make a motion that we accept the recommendation of the procurement director to renew the contract with items 1 through 4. Number 5, the buyback clause, that if Forsyth County starts its own ambulance service, that the county would purchase that equipment after an appraisal and a pro rata share or pro rata based on the length of the contract, and allow the 7% increase for 2013, which would be a total of a 10% increase, and then go back to 3% for the balance of the contract.
We have a motion.
Second for discussion. Patrick, do I understand that your motion is pretty much as presented with number five? I'm not
well. It's as presented. However, I want to be a little bit clear on the buyback, that it's not that the county could buy it, that the county would buy it.
What about the years? So you took from 2014, 2017 out, and you said 2013 only?
2013 would allow the 7% increase to a total of 10% as requested, with the remaining years being 3% as the contract already has. The remaining term of the contract has a 3% escalation.
Changing number 5, because actually read 14 through 17 and number 5.
They're asking for a 10% subsidy
for
2013, which is 7% higher than the 3% the contract states.
Right here.
Yeah, I know. I'm looking at.
And that for years 2014 through 17, it goes back to 3% for the remaining term of the contract.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay, you just wanted to clarify 2014 through 17. Yeah. Thank you.
We have a motion. We have a second for discussion.
Can I confirm one point about the motion, since I'll be drafting some of this? With respect to the buyback, and this just maybe I didn't hear it, is it a particular piece of equipment, or is it the fleet, or what was the expectation there?
Well, the way I understand it, we're asking the contractor, well, the contractor by the contract has to make improvements to the equipment.
Yes.
There's some concern now that the county may be interested in starting its own ambulance service.
Yes.
So they don't want to be in a position of spending that money and then not being able to continue the contract, because it's renewable every year, even though it's a long-term contract. I think that the way it was presented and the way I understood it, that Donna, can you help with that, or maybe we get can you help with
that? Well, I think I'm going to defer to Donna, because I think I understand what the vision is, but I just want to hear it from her real quick.
It would be the equipment that is assigned to our contract, so it would be like the ambulances and probably the equipment.
And that's a definitive list of equipment. We will know that. Okay, that's all I needed to know.
Okay, thank you.
I would, you know, when we heard this before, Mr. Rutledge was not here. And I'd like to hear, if without exception, from Mr. Rutledge for just a moment, if that's okay.
Mr.
I just want to make sure before you start that we, under the terms of this contract, we can feel we can provide adequate service to the citizens with respect to ambulance service.
What was your question again?
That under the terms of this contract, the motion that Commissioner Bell made and I seconded for discussion, that we can provide adequate service under these terms.
Yes, sir. You want me to go over why I'm asking for 7%? Okay, and I've got the 2000, I think it was 3 years ago, I met with the chief and Captain Hamilton, Captain Shivers. We talked about a seventh ambulance. Well, the money wasn't there to support a seventh ambulance in the county, you know, with the economic needs, didn't want to do it. We, I don't even think it came before the Board of Commissioners. 2008, we run 8,191 calls. 4,880 of them were transports. 2009, it was 8,142 calls with 5,168 transports. 2010 was 8,580 with 5,657 transports. 2011 was 8,798 with 6,009 transports. 2012 was 9,048 with 5,920 in transports. The county needs a seventh ambulance, but I don't know if it's feasible at this time. So I've thrown my GT truck in the mix. They pull zones probably 80% of the time, go to a posting location. We've got three posting locations. When we get to level three, we initiate the posting locations, and the ambulances move to the posting location.
You explain to the board what level threes mean, level three, level two, level one.
Units in service. And there's a lot of times we go below a level three. So there's a lot of times we're at a level zero. So
because of
call volume.
Okay.
There's a lot of times, you know, the calls come out. If any of you commissioners listen to the radio, the calls come out one after another. So I decided it was my decision to put 461 in service, which is my GT truck. It's a licensed paramedic and EMT on it. It's staffed just like the emergency trucks. They've pulled zones most of the time without getting a call. They've run about 500 calls in 2012.
What's the cost to the county for that?
I don't charge anything to the county for that. And they transported 165 of them calls. But that, I talked to Pat at 911, and she says they used to keep a book on every time an ambulance posted or whatever. They don't do that anymore. So I couldn't tell you how many times the ambulance posted, but I can tell you it's the majority of the time. And I didn't. I'm not going to put the citizens in jeopardy not providing the service. And I keep my response times down by moving trucks around to different zones. My fuel cost in 2007 was $289 a gallon, or $2.89 a gallon. It's went up and down. It's been at $4.13. Right now it's $3.97 a gallon. And with the putting 461, increases the fuel cost for me. My payroll's $2 million a year. So, I mean.
So this is a way to help offset some of the cost of this unit that you're not charging us for.
Units I'm not charging for. It's a way to offset
some. Can hold off for the expense of the 7th ambulance.
Right.
And perhaps next year you can come back.
Right.
You can come back. It would be up to the county to engage with you to determine is that 7th ambulance required.
Feasible, right. I mean, there's a zone up in Station 7 and where new Station 3 is going. They need an ambulance up there, but is it feasible now to put an ambulance up there?
Well, with the budget coming up and starting the process, I think, Doug, in March. As a matter of fact, I would like to consider, if the board's willing to, I don't know if you would be, because of that and because of Doug's background in public safety, for this next year, why don't we have you work with Doug, that you report to him, basically,
okay,
so that you can work through that process with budgeting, et cetera. Would that be all right with you, Doug?
Yes, that's fine. That's what the board...
And I'll
make that as an amendment to the motion, then.
And I apologize for not being to work session. I had a cardiology appointment. It run over. And I apologize about the budget. I didn't know when it had to be in.
I'll second the amendment.
And would you...
I've sort of lost track of where we are. Can you restate?
Well, we are discussing, in discussion on the main motion, and I kind of understand where he's at. So I amended that main motion that he would report to Doug this year so that they could work closer on this seventh ambulance to see how it would fit into the budget process. Doug's been in public safety for 25 years, so I think that he could give it a pretty good, and he's pretty, I hate to, don't please don't take this as in the wrong way, but he's pretty frugal, stingy. So if it's approved, we'll make sure that it's.
I would just ask that you clarify the motion. Is that for Mr. Rutledge and I to work together on the budget, or for Mr. Rutledge to report to me?
I would say he reports to you and works with you so that you can fine-tune it and that you have the ability to oversee the contract this year.
I think you're going to have to define reports and report? The whole scheme of the.
Mr. Rutledge is a contractor, reports to the county manager.
Who does he report to right now?
The administrator of my contract right now is the fire department.
I think that's something, a topic for another date, maybe. He's got a lot on his plate as it is.
I'm perfectly willing to do whatever the board would like me to do. I would be perfectly fine with me to work with Mr. Rutledge on the reporting and to prepare the budget. And if the board decides that, in fact, you want to modify the agreement or contract for him to report to me, I would be glad to do that as well. Entirely up to the board. But I think initially, if the motion were to be modified to have him work with me on the statistical analysis and data and work toward a budget for 2014, then I'd be glad to do that.
We have a motion, and I believe we have an amendment.
I'll second the clarification of the amendment.
If there is no further discussion, please vote on the amendment.
The amendment is to?
Is to?
That Doug becomes a contract administrator, basically, and he works with Stan next year. Doesn't obligate us to do, just work on the numbers. Okay.
There's no further discussion. Please vote on the amendment. And that passes 4-2-1. And now to the main motion. Please vote on the main motion if there's no further discussion. And that passes 3-2. Thank you very much.
Item 3.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the board. As when procurement brought renewal contracts before the board recently for 2013, you may recall that the contract for ambulance service for the year had a request in it for increase of beyond the regular 3% that's included in the current agreement, multi-year agreement, for an increase of 10% instead of a 3% increase from the prior year. The board approved that as part of the agreement for this year, and we were, of course, we're budgeted at 3% level. So what we need to bring back to the board, some of these dollars amounts were discussed, I think, at the time the contract was before the board. We need to bring back a transfer within the general fund to the board in the amount of $66,968. We're recommending that it be transferred from the general fund contingency to the ambulance service line, which will provide funding at the 10% increase level for the entire year.
Dave, one question I have for you. Future increases, will it be based on the additional $66,000, or is this a one-time?
It becomes part of the budget. It's part of the base contract. My understanding would be the next year then would be 3% on top of this. It would not go to 10% each year. It would be back to 3%.
The extra 7% would be
the new dollar level.
New dollar level. We're going to have.
And Donna, what was that number? 300 and some thousand is what it increases this contract? Over the life of the contract, this decision increases it
$300,000.
Yeah, 5 years.
Yeah, $331,000.
And although the board has approved
this addendum, I have not yet returned to you a formal amended contract. I have it before me. I just haven't gotten to it yet.
I know you don't.
Doug, I think the motion or whatever also included that they were going to report to you. Have you had a chance? One of the complaints was that people weren't paying their bill for the ambulance service. Do you have any statistics that show that?
I don't. I do not have statistics for that. Part of the board directive was to work with the ambulance service. I have met with staff, and I've met with Stan Rutledge. We actually have another meeting scheduled very soon. I've been provided some numbers with respect to the number of calls, response time, and one of the things you asked me to work on was with the ambulance services. Advanced Ambulance was in preparation of the 2014 budget that will begin very quickly, and I will work with them on that. But I do not have any numbers with respect to billing.
I don't think we would question asked you to work with billing. We didn't ask him to do anything about Stan. That was up to Stan to improve his collections.
Well, if he improves his collections, it doesn't need additional money from us.
I understand. We just asked Doug to work on another atlas direction for the board.
That was part of working on the 2014 budget, which determined the need for a seventh ambulance.
When this discussion was going on, and of course I was not on the board at the time, but I did stick my nose into it and get involved and start asking questions. And I had a conversation with Mr. Rutledge Mr. Amos did as well, where he told us outright out of his own mouth that he wasn't expecting to get the full 7% that he asked for. And I don't know why we gave it to him, especially when the procurement director and Chief Bowman both said not to. I wish that we could look at that. I look on down this agenda, and we're asking Sony Mountain Foundation to pay for an employee because we don't have enough money to pay for it. But yet we have enough to raise his contract by $300,000 in the course of the year. And it feels hypocritical to me.
The $300,000 is not 1 year.
No, it's in the course of the contract. I understand that.
He's asking mostly for this, but I understand the extra 7% to recover some fuel costs. And 11, he was providing the seventh ambulance that we were not paying for within the contract. And numbers to date, in just to the end of November, were showing that he responded to almost 500 calls with that seventh ambulance that we're not paying for in the contract.
But that wasn't the way it was presented.
That's okay, but the facts came out since then as well. And some of us already knew those facts. And I understand we're on the board at the time, and maybe you didn't have all the facts. And they also stood up there and explained that out of that, he transported 165 patients with seventh ambulance, and we do not give him any funds for compensation for the contract.
At the 165, he should have billed those for the services.
And if you look at the numbers, that compensates and offsets what we pay to make it work. I sat down with Doug and tried to figure out about the payroll would be on one of those ambulances. The payroll, according to Mr. Rutledge, I believe it says like $350,000, and the numbers I've been close to four, so somewhere in that range, he's $350,000 doesn't account the ambulance, the lease of the ambulance.
But do we manage every company's contracts that way?
We don't.
Do we handle their business for them if they can't collect from people that can't pay their bills?
That's not what he came and asked for. He came and asked for to supplement them for the fuel that he put into that extra ambulance that we don't pay for with any contract.
He did, and Chief Bowman stood up with a chart, and he showed where that was not true. He had his chart. It showed that it went some up, some down, but by and large, I mean, I was there. I saw what Chief Bowman presented.
They asked for fuel. I know that's what he asked for.
And when his fuel didn't pan out, then he said, well, maybe it's because I can't collect from 50.2% of the people I'm billing, and which he writes off.
What does that mean?
Well, I mean, it means that, I mean, no matter who the company is, it's up to them to manage their business. You hire collection agencies. You bring in your money.
Look, here's what I understood too, further from him when I talked to him. That a lot of times, multiple times every week, we're down to one, if zero ambulances available in our county, which kills response time completely. So he places his seventh ambulance in place from time to time to help us out for public safety.
I agree. If that's the case.
And it would have been smarter if he just came with us and tried to get something.
Then he should have presented it that way.
Right.
He knows how long's he been in the county. He knows how the system works. Pete brought that up at the time, that you go through the process. He should have sat down with procurement and said, I need an ambulance. I don't have an ambulance. I'm not able to do that.
I don't think he's allowed to go straight to procurement. I think he has to go through the chief. Is that correct?
It's a combination contract, but on the contractual side, it would come through me.
And in 2008, they did start coming, I guess, to Mr. Kukarola asking for something the fire department did. But it never made it to the board from what I've researched and found out, because they saw at the time the budgets were getting slashed and told them they wanted funds. Since that time, call volume was up about 25%. So if you needed an ambulance in 2008, certainly you need it today. And if the man's only looking for an extra 20-something thousand dollars to cover that, when in reality, it paid on a loan for one ambulance is 350 plus. Seems a deal for the county to me.
I thought
you were looking for 66,000. Well, 66,000, but still, payroll just on one ambulance is 350,000, not counting the lease and the insurance and all the supplies that go in.
And I urged him to stop the process and to re-present the whole thing just as you're presenting for him now.
I'm not presenting for him now. I'm just, as I dug into some of the facts, that's what I found out. Now, certainly we don't probably want to get into funding the entire ambulance in 2013 because it wasn't in our budget. That was also discussed in that. So that's where Doug Dare is going to be working with everybody to try to do for the 2014 budget.
I think we've already approved the increase.
We have.
What's before us now
we have.
Is approving a resolution to move the money from the general fund to the budget.
That's correct. So, I mean, I will agree with you. At some point, we get off task like that, the chairman should follow the vote of what we're actually discussing.
Listen, this is, you know, you have boards changing over, and you have different people involved in this issue, but the fact of the matter is, I believe, and we've already taken the action to change his budget, now we're taking the action where to move the money from. I don't know that we can go back.
I called Ken and asked him, and he said that now would be the time to do it if we were going to do it.
Is that true, Counselor?
Look, the contract is for multiple years. You know, the will of the board, as manifested in December, was to do this contract amendment. I'm working on the amendment. There's been no delay for any reason except just the fact that it's on my to-do list, but it's basically done. And I'll probably put that on a future agenda just to ratify it. But you've already approved this action. So, Commissioner Tam, I agree with you. However, if a board member at any time has concerns about the funding, this is as good a time as any to bring them up because you're talking about the funding.
And it wasn't budgeted.
So, I mean, I believe the question was, can this be an appropriate discussion for purposes of the agenda item? You know we've had in this discussion, in this chamber, is this an appropriate line of questioning related to this agenda item, and there's been times we've decided, no, it's not. You need to put that on a future agenda. The question, as Mills said, is can I bring this up now within the context of funding it? And my answer was, absolutely.
Certainly. Argument here. I just was pointing out that the board has already taken the action.
I know that you all know that, but yes, that's true.
Can you actually change the funding today?
I don't think, and again, I don't want to speak for anybody, you all are all capable. I don't think that was the purpose of the discussion to change the contract today. I don't think that's what we're doing today. I think it was to raise issues that were of concern about a member that's got a vote on this funding. If you want to change the deal, we'll have to go back out to Advance Ambulance and say, we want to change the deal.
It concerns me because he said to two of us that he wasn't expecting to get the full thing. He could go for less. And we knew that.
Why did he ask for it?
When does his contract come up for renewal?
It has another 4 years.
Do we approve it every year?
Yes, it comes back. It's an automatic 3% and it has to come back.
Well, when does it come back to the board?
Remember, it does automatically renew. I'll just put a mint in my mouth, forgive me. It does automatically renew, but also by way of affirmative action, you can end it at the end of each calendar year.
So this renews every year automatically 3% in it.
3%.
So we added the 7% for just 1 year?
But that it's cumulative. It's added on. You've added the 7%, so it's at this level. So next
3%
year.
So 3% then adds on to
and
the
3%. And that's why it's the $350 some odd thousand over the life.
So next year would be cumulatively a 13% increase over 2000.
3%, yes. Right.
Well, Ms. Mills, honestly, if you wanted to adjust that sum, I'm okay with that. I don't have a problem with that either. But I think it's something that we ought to do through Ms. Kukarola in a different manner and postpone this item if need be to look into that. We got a lot of information from a lot of different angles from a lot of different people.
And it nothing, wasn't handled right.
And nothing beginning. Was laid out where we all gathered the information at the same time, the same way. I would agree with you on that.
Do I hear anybody wants to postpone it then to talk further about this item?
I'll postpone it, what, for 30 days to two work sessions away?
February 12th.
For the discussion in case we want to adjust this contract.
Is that okay?
Or does that mess you up terribly?
Well, I just have a question for you. I know that the advanced ambulance will want to be paid for January and in February prior to making a final decision.
Well, that's a good segue for me.
What amount will I pay?
My marching orders are to bring you a revised contract. That's what the board approved. And until you tell me by way of formal action differently, I'm going to be bringing you a modified contract, hopefully with Stan Rutledge's signature on it.
So there's no way we could adjust that 7% today down to an additional 4%?
You could, but you would need 5%? Forgive me, committee. Yeah, yes, you could, and you would need to, but what you need to do would be to rescind that agreement. And I will say, to Ms. Mills' point already, I don't think that's an appropriate topic for today. While I do think it was okay to talk about the funding, I don't think you all can rescind a contract that wasn't on the agenda. But that's perfectly appropriate. If y'all want to put that on the next work session to discuss rescission, I don't think Mr. Rutledge is going to care.
Why don't we try to get January 22nd?
January 22nd.
If it passes, we can pay him for January.
Right, because he expects payment the first of each month.
We'll hold him off that far?
Yeah. I will call him today.
That's a big, and how much is that monthly check?
$80,000.
$3%. Can you pay him on the last contract
and then readjust February's to whatever we change? I think for Mr. Rutledge, to be fair, I think that he as a vendor has every right to believe he's got a deal for this new increased amount. I mean, I know it's not been memorialized in agreement. I agree with that. But from his perspective, you said we agree.
I agree though.
My thought would be, let's bring it back. Y'all are agreeable, of course, but let's bring it back in the next work session in January after perhaps Donna's reached out to him. At a minimum, she can go ahead and pay under the old agreement with the understanding that whatever we work out as a difference will supplement that extra amount.
Can we do 4/5 and add it to the last item of today? Nope.
Yeah, well, why don't we just bring it back to the
next one?
Sounds like some people want to see.
Well, you're looking at a vendor that. And I don't know his business, but I mean, he's got a pretty large payroll.
Donna says she could adjust it without the...
Can you?
Yeah.
We'll hold up his check up.
That's fair enough.
You could pay him under the old agreement with the difference.
Or we could even pay him because the board approved, and I'm just talking paid the full amount, and if the board changes, then it could be adjusted. Is that correct?
We can do it that way, or if you'd like to just pay him under the old agreement with the notion that whatever you all agree to in the next work session, we would then upfront the balance, the difference between what we didn't pay him. It's just a matter of whether you want to chase money or not, is the only question.
I don't think we want to chase money.
Well, we pay the check, so we would reduce the payments.
That's
fair enough. All right.
We're not chasing money. That's true.
Either way, we just shouldn't leave a vendor hanging because we haven't finalized our decision.
Do we need to revise this motion, Counselor? Withdraw that and then talk about how we're going
to
pay him?
I think all you need to do respectfully is just postpone it until the next work session.
Okay, made a motion to postpone February 12th.
I withdraw my second.
Okay, now.
Yeah, just to the next work session.
I withdraw my motion, and the motion will be to postpone this item. So next work session, along with adding the other discussion of adjusting the 7% possibly to a 4 or 5%.
That's satisfactory. That's fine.
To the January 22nd. Have a second.
Second.
All in favor, please vote. Let's say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carries 5-0.
And I will tell you that the amendment's done, and if Donna has success, literally it'll be as easy as changing a figure on the amendment. Won't be hard at all.
Thank you. The original item 4 has been postponed, the Amber Watson to January 22nd, and the new item 4, Civil Service and Charity Clark.
Mr. Chairman, may I respectfully, before we get into this one, may I respectfully ask for a 5-minute recess?
Yes. 5 minute recess.
Without exception.
I see.
I love recess.